Antarctica is the 800-pound gorilla of climate change. Really. Okay. It's huge. It contains enough ice to raise sea levels by 190 feet, roughly.
Oh, really? Yeah. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's a lot. It's a lot. It's definitely melting. We don't really think that it's going to all melt, like, in our lifetime. So Antarctica is losing ice, and we know this very very definitively. There were a couple of satellites that used to fly around, or they still do. There's a second pair. They're called GRACE. And they actually had separate names. It was two satellites, and they sort of chase each other around. And they're called Tom and Jerry.
You climate scientists are very clever people. You really
so
are.
So silly. And we like cartoons. And whenever one went over something heavy, then the pull of gravity would literally cause it to speed up and pull away from the other one. So by measuring the distance between the two as they go forward and backward, you can literally like weigh the continents.
Get the hell out of here,
yeah.
Really.
Yeah, yeah. So you can weigh Antarctica, you can weigh Greenland, you know, you can weigh the Central Valley. And the reason you see the mass change is almost always because of water. So in the Central Valley, it's because we pump the groundwater out. And in Antarctica, it's because these giant chunks of ice are breaking off from the edges and flooding out into the oceans.
That is really interesting. Okay, so they're measuring it because of the way these satellites interact with each other.
Right.
Is the way they make that measurement, but they're actually weighing it, and they're discovering that Antarctica is getting less.
It's definitely losing mass. You know, for 20 or 30 years ago, there was a debate about whether or not it was melting at all, mm-hmm. whether or not it was really losing mass, and that satellite totally ended that debate. But some new research actually just came out this week that suggests that we really worried about West Antarctica and the Antarctic Peninsula. The peninsula is the part that kind of sticks up and points at the southern tip of South America. And that's melting because it's higher latitude and it's warmer climate. And West Antarctica, we've known, has been melting for a long time, but this recent work suggests that East Antarctica is actually also starting to melt from the warming of the oceans nearby.
Jeez,
so. Yeah, and it's another, you know, the Antarctic Peninsula and West Antarctica is a few meters, and then the chunks of East Antarctica that are melting is a potential few meters. Greenland is 7 or 8 meters of potential sea level rise. So you put all these things together, all the things that are threatened, and now we're looking at like tens of meters or 30 or 40 feet of sea level rise. That's a potential over maybe 100 years. Maybe a couple hundred years, but we just don't know how fast it's going to melt.
Wow. Okay. So, so none of this is good, but it all seems to suggest that. And tell me if I'm right about this. It seems like the trend for climate science is that it is the estimates are worsening as we go.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is that about right?
That's right. You know, I mean, and it kind of makes sense because we're discovering how this. Thing is working as we go, right? I mean,
we're discovering the depth of how screwed we are as we dig in.
Yeah, to put the nerdy scientist spin on it, you know, we're doing an experiment with the planet.
Nice point,
right?
Dexter.
Exactly, right? Uh-huh, uh-huh. We had this planet and it had a climate, and for 10,000 years or so, the climate was very stable, and that's when we developed our civilization. And now we're just driving that climate into like a warm, into a warmer and warmer place. And
we'll see how this version of civilization works
out. Yeah, so we'll see how that goes. That's right, exactly.